Welcome to the 2019-2020 Rectory School Holiday Chapel. So this one's called Lessons and Carols. This marks a special occasion, a special time of the year for all of us. So this chapel service ties together the two stories that serve as one of the greatest influences in Western culture: the Jewish holiday of Hanukkah and the celebration of the coming of Jesus, who some call the Christ, Christmas. So we will use readings and musical pieces and hymns that we sing together to celebrate these two ancient traditions of faith. This space has seen many classes, students, teachers come and go. If you haven't noticed, just take a look around at this beautiful space. It's always a blessing to come here, whatever age you are, and just to see the stained glass, the inscriptions on the wood, not to mention the organ. It has heard many secrets, held hundreds of celebrations, and also laid many to rest when they have passed on from this life. And now you are a part of this long line of life, relationships between students, alumni, and faculty, and the marking of time. But to bring it back to right here, right now, I invite you all to take a few deep breaths, sit a little straighter in your chair or pew, and bring your attention to this moment. I know there's a lot wrapping up in school, academics, athletics, especially with the schedule change and the weather, but just let it go for a bit. It'll be there when you leave. As the disciple Peter once said to the master teacher, "It is good for us to be here." The spirit of Christmas and Hanukkah are universal spirits of good feeling. So you'll notice, due to the changed schedule this morning, we did have to adjust, so we've cut out a few tunes. So also forgive the hymns that we've cut out, and also we've made a couple errors in the program, so please be gracious about that. I noticed the hymns are upside down, printer problems. You'll notice that some of the songs that are listed in the program, especially in the middle pamphlet, are written in bold letters. And so please sing along with those songs. So that's all together, sing along. No voices are hindered. That's the real spirit of it. And last thing, we ask that you hold your applause. This one's critical. So let's hold our applause completely until the very, very end, where we acknowledge everyone, and all the musicians, and all the readers. Okay. Again, welcome to our holiday chapel service, and enjoy the program.
Commemorating the rededication of the Holy Temple and the miracle that occurred there long ago. The Maccabees fought their enemies to keep the temple pure and to worship as they wished. They defeated their enemies, but the holy oil needed to light the menorah had been contaminated. There was only enough oil for one day, but miraculously, this oil lasted for 8 days. The Maccabees decreed that these 8 days must be kept forever as a joyous festival in memory of the dedication to the temple.
Since that time, for more than 2,000 years, these days have been celebrated in every Jewish home as the days of rededication or Hanukkah. By lighting a menorah on each of the 8 nights of Hanukkah, candles are lit, one the first night, two the second, adding one candle each subsequent night. One candle, called a shamash, is used to light the others. The first candle for the first night is placed on the far right side of the menorah. Starting on the second night, the candles are lit from left to right.
pray together. Merciful God, you have bestowed upon us gifts beyond our imagining and have reminded us all that we have belongs to you alone and is merely held in trust by human hands. We give you thanks for those moments of reconciliation and grace we see in our world, of wrongs that are made right, knowing that in your love all things are possible, inspiring our nation, its leaders, and people, a spirit of greater sacrifice and devotion in the use of our treasures for the reconciliation of your world, that in forsaking wealth and giving up ourselves to walk in the way of the cross, we may find it to be none other than the way of real life and peace. Eternal God, in whose perfect kingdom no sword is drawn but the sword of righteousness, no strength known but the strength of love, so mightily spread abroad your spirit, that all peoples may be gathered together and reconciled under the banner of the Prince of Peace, as children of one Father, to whom be dominion and glory, now and forever. Amen. Now we'll have our first reading.
There shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesus, and a branch from his roots shall bear fruit, and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, and his delight shall be the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide disputes of what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth, and he shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt of his waist, and faithfulness the belt of his loins. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, and the calf and the lion, and the fattened calf together, and the little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the cobra, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come up upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child will be called holy, the Son of God."
Registered with Mary, his wife, who was with his child, and will they were there. And this came from her birth to give birth, and she gave birth to his firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod, the king, behold, whose men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he who was born King of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him. When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And assembling all the chief priests and scribes and the people, he inquired of them who the Christ was to be born. And they told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it is written by the prophet, 'And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who will shepherd the people of Israel.'" Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and learned from them what time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word, so I too may come and worship him." After listening to the king, they went on their way. And behold, the star that they had seen when it rose went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshiped him. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way.
Nor of human will, but of God's will. And the Word became flesh and dwelled among us. And we have seen its glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Lord, He is born. Lord, He is born. Lord, Lord, He is born.
final blessing, then we'll have our final applause for everybody, all the participants. And then as we leave, on your way out, in a civil manner, on our way out, you'll hear our last amazing piece, performed by the group up there. Hark the Herald. We won't sing it all together, even though it's in bold, as the asterisk. We won't sing it all together. It is exit music. It is exit music. Let us pray. Let us go here, from here now, with grateful hearts and more enlightened eyes. Let us remember that the heart of life is good. Teach us how to speak with kindness. Teach us how to listen well. We pray for safe travels for all students and faculty. We ask you to keep each other in your prayers so we can know that we support each other in good and difficult times. May this prayer be the prayer of all of us here together. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is excellent, think about and celebrate these things. Amen. Amen.